You may start.
Okay. Hi, my name is Vladimir, and I'm going to be presenting on my project, NDVI Time Series Analysis using Google Earth Engine and Sentinel-2. So to begin, I wanted to explain NDVI a little bit. So it's a normalized difference vegetation index. It's to generally measure how vegetation and crop health is happening remotely using Sentinel-2 imagery in this case. And plants that are healthier usually have a higher NDVI, and plants that are less healthy have a low NDVI. And it's calculated with this formula that incorporates near-infrared and red light. And I chose to use Sentinel-2 imagery for this project, whereas usually for a time series, Landsat or MODIS is used. But I figured with this new technology, and as time goes on, Sentinel-2 will be a better tool for analyzing vegetation and crop health. And Sentinel-2 has a spatial resolution of 10 meters and a temporal resolution of 4 days. So the satellite goes over each part of the Earth within like a 4 day period. And the study area was Yuma County, Arizona. I chose to do a subdivision of Yuma County, which was also goes by the name of Yuma. And Yuma County has the Colorado and Gila rivers flowing through it, and that's how they receive most of their water supply. And Yuma County is a huge agricultural center in Arizona. It ranks top 1% in sales of all crop and livestock products in the U.S. And it has senior water rights, so it receives its full allocation of water in times of drought, compared to junior water rights holders, which may face bigger cutbacks in drought periods. And right now, the Southwest U.S. is going through a mega drought, which is a period of over 20 years of very high severity drought. Studies have observed, based on tree ring chronologies, that current drought rivals the worst drought in recorded history, which was in the 1500s. And studies have observed based on, water rights in the Colorado River Basin are determined by prior appropriation, where the water use is allocated based on a first come, first served basis. So those that came first received senior water rights, and those that came after received junior water rights. And owners must show beneficial use, referred to as the use it or lose it rule, which results in many agricultural use holders to flood their fields with water so as to preserve their full allocation of water, whether they need it or not, which produces really wasteful use of water. So climate change and outdated water laws fuel this mega drought situation. And the data I used was from a Google Earth Engine. I used the Sentinel-2 Level 2A data archive. And for that I made a time series there, and I also exported 4 individual images for analysis in ArcGIS Pro. So Google Earth Engine is kind of a cloud computing software that's available online, where it has a high computing volume, so you can analyze hundreds of images at once instead of using like a desktop software where you can only do so much with what your computer can handle. And I also used the Arizona County Subdivision shapefile from the United States Census Bureau. And this is kind of a summary of my methods that I used for the time series and a preview of what it looked like. So first I imported the county subdivisions, imported the Sentinel-2 image collection, filtered out just for the study area, and I got only images that had less than 5% cloud cover, retained the vegetation or bare soil pixels, masked the clouds, computed NDVI, plotted the NDVI time series, and displayed a mean NDVI to show how Google Earth Engine is processing the data. And so to begin, I imported the Sentinel-2 data archive, imported the county subdivision, and then I filtered out to only have my subdivision that I was studying. And then I got my date range, made it so that only the Sentinel-2 images with less than 5% cloud cover would be analyzed. And I filtered out the cloud cover. And you can kind of see here how this is what an image with 5% cloud cover would look like. It does not have as much clouds, so you could see more of the Earth. And I also removed pixels that aren't vegetation and soil. So Sentinel-2 images have an SCL layer, which allows you to, which has like classifications for pixels. And this made it so that focuses on vegetation and bare soil and not on urban areas or other classifications. And then I extracted the data, the NDVI data for further analysis. I plotted the time series and you could kind of see it's a weird time series from what you usually see, but that's because the study area was located between two Sentinel-2 tiles. So it was incorporating both of those. And I averaged these to get the final time series. And to observe how Google Earth Engine is filtering and interpreting the data, I made it so that Google Earth Engine can display the data. And you could see the red areas are areas that are not incorporated, and green and yellow areas are incorporated and show the NDVI values. And then to get a better, more specific analysis, I did individual images. And this is kind of the results where I had these four images for one for each year in the month of May. And I downloaded and imported these images from Google Earth Engine, converted pixel values to NDVI, created a symbology scheme, extracted by mask and reclassified. And then I applied the symbology from layer. And in Google Earth Engine, you can select which bands you want and export that image. And then I classified it in ArcGIS Pro using the NDVI built-in function. And I created a symbology scheme. And then I extracted by mask to just have my study area, reclassified the pixels so that it displayed properly. And then I applied the symbology from layer from the previously created one. And then for the results of the time series, I looked at temperature and precipitation. And there was nothing really out of balance in these graphs since it's just a 4-year period. The temperature is generally stable. And for the precipitation, it's as expected. It's pretty low in this area. And here's the raw NDVI values where you could see that values are trending downward, which could indicate that the vegetation health is declining. And here's a 5-point bandwidth. It's just an average of 5 days. It makes the chart smoother and more coherent. And you could also see the downward trend and also how the variation changed from starting at a high point in the winter month of January and then going to low in the summer and then high and low. But then in 2022, you could see that you don't get the same high value that you saw in the previous years, which could indicate that there could indicate more impacts of the drought happening and a decline in vegetation health. And this is a time lapse of the NDVI values. You could see 2019, more green. You could see the different crop rotations happening. But in 2022, you could see it's much less green. And that could be attributed potentially to the drought. And looking at the specific pixel values in that uncategorized classified NDVI values, you could see that for the year 2022, there's no values for the high, for the healthy vegetation. And you could see a decline from the moderately or like the less, the more healthy to less healthy vegetation from 0.0, to point one, from the point one to point two. And then when you categorize them, it's much more of a clear picture, and you could see how there's no well-irrigated, healthiest vegetation compared to areas and where you could see an uptick in the weakly irrigated, sparse vegetation for that year. And then these are just the individual images. You can see some trends where there was like maybe more vegetation in 2020 in areas that weren't agricultural, but maybe some areas that were more weakly irrigated in 2020. And then in 2022, you really see the decline of the well-irrigated, healthy vegetation from 2021 to 2022. And in conclusion, overall crop and vegetation health in the Yuma County subdivision is trending downward, and periods of extended drought caused by climate change and these outdated water laws are resulting in worse crop health. And just to present some limitations of the study, there was for data availability, since it was Sentinel 2, I could only analyze the 4 years that were available. And it had an uneven time scale due to the cloud cover. So I couldn't project into the future what the trend could look like in the future. And I analyzed only the Yuma County subdivision. So it would be good for future studies to analyze other areas, maybe areas with junior water rights where they might even have less water availability. And for recommendations, land managers, farmers can shift towards crops that are less water intensive. Water laws need to be changed and to incentivize less wasteful water practices, and maybe incentivize crops that are more drought tolerant and use less water, and analyze NDVI images to identify areas of excess water use. You could apply the soil index or NDVI to see if there's areas where there's excess water use. And then further studies can analyze the junior water rights, as I said, and incorporate additional spectral indices such as the soil moisture index. And using Google Earth Engine, you can continually monitor the Sentinel-2 images that are released and see the trend going forward. All right, thank you.